Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. It is nice to have you with us today. You know, and thank you very much for that lovely kiss. It was nice. I like to do that. What a nice way to start things rolling. We have something for you today. Please don't go away. We have three wonderful couples, as we are want. Make a sentence out of that. You know what I mean. They've got me misogynoir already, and here they are. Winning money today for the blue section, Tony Fields and her husband, Georgie Johnston.
What did you just say? I have no idea what you just said.
I have no idea.
And I've never seen an entire audience go...
Well,
what did you say, sweetheart?
I just said that we have a crazy bunch of people, which is our want.
Lovable. Yes, the word is lovable.
That's what I meant to say.
Not crazy. All right, John.
Yeah, lovable. That's what I meant to say.
You look awful cute today.
Thank you. So do you. And do you too, George?
Thank you.
Can you hear me, George?
Yes, I can hear you.
Oh, those earphones look great with your hair.
Oh, do they?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's...
You should wear them that way always.
Pressing it down a little bit.
Winning money today for the banana section, we have Ross Martin and his wife, Olivia Martin. I don't know what it is. My tongue is not working correctly. I think I know.
That about you, Bert.
I think I know what's going to happen. I know it's going to get crazy, and I'm waiting for it. I mean,
you
it's going to get lovable. Is what
Bert,
I mean.
I love when you're on this side because we get to see that dimple. You know, your left dimple is much deeper than the right.
Honey, will you be quiet?
You mean my husband can hear? Really, it is. Look at that, Tony.
Oh,
is that adorable?
I didn't know that before.
I don't take him with me everywhere I go for nothing.
Anyway, it's lovely to have you both here again.
Oh, it's
thank
so
you.
Much fun being back.
Glad we didn't ask the flirting question this show.
Yeah.
Winning money today for the red section. There he is, first time with us, and we're thrilled to have him. Mr. Jerry Vale and his wife, Rita Vale.
Thank you, Bert. This is really fun.
What was that, babe?
I said this is really fun.
Isn't this fun?
Yes.
I told you you'd have fun. It's really good fun. And you're going to enjoy yourself.
Quietest all the quietest I have ever seen Rita since I know her.
Really? Oh, but we'll get warmed up, won't we, Jerry?
Give her time.
Here we go. Here's the first question. It's worth $150. This is it. Man, you and your wife check into one of the so-called adult motels, simply because there are no other motels around. That's the reason. Mm-hmm. In your room, you discover a coin-operated TV camera aimed at the bed, which will make a tape of you, play it back, and then self-destruct. What? Would you use it? Would you use that tape machine? Off you go. Well, now, Tony, no one will ever know. No one will ever see it but you and Georgie.
You don't understand. When I get into bed and I'm ready for Georgie, I call him. I turn out the lights and he comes into the room.
Yes.
And he's very shy. My husband has a lovely, darling, shy quality, which I love. And why would we want to see ourselves doing anything when you can enjoy it without seeing it? No, that would embarrass me.
It would embarrass you?
And my husband would never allow it.
He wouldn't?
Never. Never.
Okay.
Let me say this. He would never allow it with me. With Rita, maybe, you know. Olivia, you for sure.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
But with me?
Okay. Well, then if you want to pick one of those up, you'll have to go. Oh, no, I'm sorry. So you'll say no.
Absolutely.
Would not use it. Here he comes. So, Georgie, there you and Tony are. You're alone.
Right.
No one else around.
Right.
No one else is ever going to see this.
No, this is the Blue Haven Motel?
Yes.
I think, okay.
We stayed at the Blue Haven.
Right.
And they did have...
Yes, they have those things there.
Well, what happens? Would you use it if you...
Between Tony and I are there, right, in the bedroom alone.
There you are alone.
We definitely would not use
That's it. Right. That's what you said.
There you go. Bert. Bert.
Yes, George.
We might be tempted to make it as a pilot for a situation comedy.
You'd show it to America, but you don't want to see it, right?
Min and Bill.
The Bickersons at it again. Thank you, George. Olivia, what will Ross say?
I think he's going to say no for a number of reasons. Mm. The reasons are very similar to those that Tody gave. We don't need that kind of kick. Plus, I don't trust these things that say destruct. I wouldn't give you a nickel for anything that says it destructs. You know darn well they're going to have it.
Maybe. Oh, sure. It's probably closed circuit down to the lobby.
Are you kidding?
Look at room 32 up there. Wow.
Imagine our children going to the movies and seeing starring Ross Martin at the Blue Haven Motel. No.
I would need widescreen if you were with me.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to say if we need wide or narrow, because then you'd know everything.
I don't want to know.
Okay. But I'm going to say no.
The answer is no, you would not use it. Here comes Ross. Ross, there you are, the two of you, alone.
Yes.
You're in this motel.
Yes.
There's the camera pointed at the bed.
Oh, yes.
And the right time comes.
Yes.
No one will ever see this tape but you and Oliver.
Darn.
Oh, I said the wrong thing. Would you use that camera or not?
Now, by you mean the singular you. You mean me.
No, you and Oliver. You're there together.
Yes, I know, but would I be the one to use the camera? I mean, I'd be the one to push the button.
Well, it is worded, would you use it?
I'd use it.
No, that's not what Oliver said. Oliver, what do you think of that, huh?
Honey, it's Oliver. This is Oliver.
Yes, you wouldn't use it at all. I'd use it.
You'd use it.
But I'm there.
Interesting.
Ross, you know what?
Yes?
This is Tony. You're a pig.
We're all animals, Tony. We're
all animals. That's what he says. He's an animal. No, but that's interesting. He would like to see you wouldn't, but he answered for him. He
yes,
would
when you
like
said
to.
Would you, I thought you meant you.
I
me.
Did.
You.
I'm asking it. You the question. Interesting,
funny.
Huh? Now you know.
So you never know.
Pick yourself up a little camera.
I know.
Thank you, Ross. I'm sorry.
You never know anyone until you know.
Rita, what will Jerry say?
I think that Jerry would ask me to leave and record two sides in front of the camera. That's what I think. No, I'm only kidding. I think Jerry would say no. Absolutely not.
He wouldn't do it.
No, never.
Okay.
He wouldn't do it.
Yeah, I'm asking
he didn't
him.
Say I wouldn't do it, but he wouldn't do
would
it.
Would you do
no,
it?
No, I'm only kidding. No, you
yes,
didn't
George.
Ask me that.
I'd like to put a quarter in if I could.
Never mind, George. We already know about you.
Wait a minute. Tony said
no,
that
in
Georgie
Jerry's.
And I would
yeah,
do it.
I know,
not
but
Jerry
that's what Tony
I
said. She said you'd look at one of the other two couples in a minute. But you don't count now. You've got your money.
No, Jerry would not. Other than recording, he doesn't. He wouldn't sing.
Only on wax.
Or do anything.
Not on tape, only on wax. Here he comes.
Never.
Jerry, there you are, you and Rita alone, the motel room. There's the camera pointed at the bed. And you're going to have an opportunity to make this tape. No one else will ever see it.
Mm-hmm.
It will self-destruct. Would you do it?
No.
That's right. That's what you said. I thought he was going to say
it. He thought about it a long time.
You got it. Rita and Jerry, Tony and Georgie split the pot and a half. We'll come back in a moment with a lot more. Stay where you are. See you in a moment. You ready to go, gang? Here we go. Question number two coming up. This is it. $150 riding on this one. Whoopee, men. Women can say many things with their eyes, but which can your wife say better with hers? Come hither. Or stay away.
Oh, it's that.
Okay? It's a good question. Think about it. You've
toughy.
Seen those looks, I'm
toughy.
Sure. Off you go, fellas. Ross seemed to find a little amusement in that question, Olivia. What will the answer be?
I think he's still laughing from the last question.
What can you say better? Yes.
Oh, I
up.
Think he's going to say, stay away.
Stay away.
That my eyes... give me the question.
Well, it's said like this, but which can your wife say better with hers? Come hither or stay away? Say many things with your eyes.
I think he's going to say stay away. I don't know why.
Mm-hmm.
I think so.
What kind of look do you give him when you want him to stay away?
I don't give him any kind of a look. It's a nothing.
It's
look.
A kick.
Yeah. I'm going to say that.
But you're going to say that's the one that you can do better.
Oh, wouldn't it be awful to go home losers? But I, because I really don't say it with my eyes when I want it.
Oh. What?
Just out of curiosity, what do you say it with, Olivia?
Well, you said come hither.
Yes.
And that usually implies, you know.
That's the look.
You're right.
That's the one. You're going to say stay away, though. He's the one with the eyes.
Well, because of the way the question's worded.
All right. Okay.
Now, and you word it to him just the way you gave it to me.
I will. I'll do it again just that way. So it's stay away. Here he comes. Ross, now,
yes.
women can say things with their eyes,
yes.
many ways. Which can your wife say better with hers, come hither or stay away?
You really have put me in a box, haven't you?
Yes, in a little television box. Right?
Yes, because I can tell you that just in terms of Olivia, she can, if she cares to, frost someone at 100 paces.
Yes.
But her come hither look is the most glorious, the most gorgeous,
yes.
the most fabulous I have ever seen.
Yeah.
Despite the fact that it is that great, the thing that has the power is that 100 yards stay away.
That's the one. That's what she said. Frost him at 100 yards, eh?
If she wants to.
Well,
if
she
wants
to,
she can freeze. I've never seen any. She can absolutely frost somebody, freeze them.
Really?
At 100 yards.
Thank you, Ross. Rita, what would Jerry say?
I'm trying to figure out the question.
Oh. Which can you say better with your eyes?
You mean me personally?
I'm asking Jerry, but we're talking about you. Do you do better with the come hither look, or do you do better with the stay away look?
You mean to Jerry or to?
Yes, to Jerry. Unless you'd like to say, come hither to me, all right.
Tony, what should I say? No, I think Jerry would say...
Jerry knows when to stay away.
That's true. I would say, come hither.
Come hither. Come hither is the one. All right, here he comes. I know it's tough, Jerry. Which does Rita do better with her eyes? Come hither or stay away?
Well, it's tough because she does both very well.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh. Yeah.
I would think she would probably say, stay away.
No.
Jerry, how could you say
no,
that?
No, she. Guess what she said.
What did she say? Tell me.
She said, come hither. Sorry about that, Jerry. Tony, what will Georgie say?
This is without any conversation involved.
That's right, just the eyes.
It's just eyes.
Yeah.
Because everything I do verbally, you know? I say, what do you think, you know? I never say come hither with my eyes.
No.
But boy, when I give him one of my looks, he's scared.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the look.
It's the look. Yeah, stay away is the look.
It's that. He knows when
to... When to stay away.
Oh, yeah. He stayed away once 3 years.
Just from one little look, huh?
Just one look, that's all.
Blinked your eyes, and he was gone. It's stay away is the look. Here he comes. Georgie, which...
Yes, Bert.
...can Toady say better with her eyes? Would it be come hither or stay away?
She's very, very good at the come hither look.
No, she said to stay away from us. Olivia and Ross, get the whole thing
hey,
at halftime, ladies. If you will step to the rear, we'll bring the gentlemen out front. We'll come back with the second half of Title Tales in a moment. Don't you miss this now. See you in a moment. Oh, this is a good one. We've changed places after halftime. I have the fellas with me. Ladies, I got a good question for you. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections. Many people believe in reincarnation. True. Have you ever had the feeling that you lived before in a previous life? Yes or no? Okay, think that over. Some people believe in it, and of course some people do not. What about Rita, Jerry?
I would have to say that yes, because many times we've been driving in a car, and she would say, I have the feeling that I've been here before, or in the house, or with friends at a party, and so on and so forth.
And so she believes in...
I would think that she would say yes to that.
Okay. Did she ever tell you what she thought she might have been, or where she was, or when it was?
No, I don't want to know.
Oh, okay. Maybe we'll find out from her. Here she comes. Rita, have you ever had the feeling that you lived before in a previous life? Yes or no?
Yes, I have. I've
That's been. Right. That's what he said.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to know who I think I was?
Oh, I sure would.
Well, we've discussed it many times, haven't we, Reet?
We have.
What do you think that you were or who you were or when it was?
Don't tell me a stripper.
Oh, next. I think I did live before. I really feel that way. And I think I was living during the Roaring Twenties, and I was Al Capone's wife.
Right. Okay. Hey, listen. You a ask a question, you get an answer.
Another Italian.
Jerry, another Italian. What can I tell you?
Oh, teach me not to ask.
Georgie, what will Tody say to this?
Yes, she feels that she lived before.
Yeah. Definitely. I hope she so. Wasn't married to Al Capone, too, no. Because it'd be kind of crowded.
Elliot Ness, she was married to Elliot Ness. She definitely, I'm sure she feels that she has. Lived at another time.
Okay, interesting. See, I think a lot of us share that. Let's bring her on. Tody, have you ever had the feeling that you lived before in a previous life?
Well, this may come as a shock to you, but I was once a count.
Is that right?
Well, I was. I was Count Umberto. A lady told me I was.
Really?
Yes.
So the answer is yes, of course.
Oh, of course.
Well, you got that right. Now let's... somebody...
And do you want to know something?
Yes.
To this day, I'm still shaving.
Thank you, Count. I mean, thank you, Tody. Ross, what will Olavi say? Fascinating.
There's no question about it. She was, and it was during Old Egypt, and she was a dancing girl.
Really?
She will say yes.
Did she have a mystic tell her that?
That's her own conviction.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Let's bring her on. We could do a whole show on this. Mm. Olavi, have you ever had the feeling that you lived before in a previous life?
I feel for sure that I have many times.
That's right. That's what Ross said. Wow. Isn't that something?
I believe that I will live many times again. Yes.
You do?
I truly believe
You're
that.
You're still right. You're all right.
I'd like to live with George Segal again.
Never mind. Here we go. We spin it. We'll come back with our $300 question and decide the game for the day in just a moment. Hang on. We have a very good close game, in case you hadn't noticed. Olavi and Ross have 200, and Rita, you and Tody have 125. Very close, but this one's worth $300. Here we go. Ladies, which one of you has more expensive tastes, you or your husband? Think it over, and we'll come back in a moment. Off you go. We will start with you, Georgie.
This is hands down Tody.
Yeah? Oh, they all think they've got this one.
She's a shopper.
A shopper.
I told her I'm going to enter her next year in the next Olympics.
Yeah.
Cross-country shopping.
Cross-country shopping.
She's going to take all three medals.
All three medals, eh? Cross-country shopping. Let's bring on Count Umberto now. Count? I just love that. Which one of you has more expensive taste, you or Georgie?
Well, I don't know if Georgie has told you this, but he wants to enter me in the 1980 Olympics.
Yes.
In cross-country shopping.
That's it. You got it. He did. He did tell us that. And the winner, Count Umberto. Thank you, Tody. Jerry, what will Rita say?
Well, we got off the plane from Las Vegas to come here.
Uh-huh.
We got in the hotel at 12 midnight, and my wife said, "Where can I shop?" So
really?
There's not a question in my mind that she has more expensive taste than I do.
She does. Okay.
Yes.
That's where can I shop? Yeah. Here she comes. And here you can find a place. There you are. Rita, which one of you has more expensive taste, you or Jerry?
Definitely me.
That's it. You got it. All right, now.
That's the first time he's ever kissed if I have any more expensive things.
This is it. You can win it for the bananas right here, Ross. It's one?
It's one.
No question about it?
No question in my mind at all.
Tell us
about it. Our usual line is, I've got two kinds of news for you when we come into a new town. Good news and bad news. And I say, give me the bad news first. She says, there's an antique shop downstairs. I said, what's the good news? She says, it's closed. She can spend more in a month than I'll spend on my clothes in a year. She's a great shopper. And really is careful, but she's the biggest spender by far.
All right, it's Olavi, I think, is what he's trying to tell us, and here she comes now. Olavi, between you and Ross, who would you say had more expensive tastes?
I believe I do.
That's right, you got it. You've all got it, we split it three ways. However, the banana section with Olivia and Roz have won it for the day. We shall return in just a moment and let you know how much the bananas have won. Don't go away. And they're going, guess what? Big winners, the banana section with Ross and Olivia with $300. We want to add $1,000, $1,300. Not bad.
That's a lot of bananas.
Oh, yes. Can we look for you in something soon, Ross?
Well, on television, you mean?
Wherever.
Well, I'll be in Milwaukee fairly soon, starring in 1776.
Oh, lovely. That's
and
wonderful.
On July the 4th, which is the last day of the show, to celebrate the 200th anniversary of the country,
that'll
I'll be signing
be
the Declaration of Independence on stage.
That's exciting. All right, we'll watch for you in Milwaukee. We'll watch for all of you here next time, and I hope you watch for us next time on Tattletales. Bert Comet saying so long, everybody. Bye.